Friend Mike Lindell. Good morning, Mr. Lindell.
Good morning, Mr. Imus.
How you doing, baby?
I'm doing great. I've been busy since I haven't talked to you in a while. It's lots happening.
So how many, first of all, how many pillows have you guys sold so far?
32 million.
32 million?
Yeah.
You know, I saw a bunch of your trucks. I'm about 80 miles from Houston. And tell me about that project.
Yeah, I sent down 60,000 pillows a couple weeks ago and a couple crews to make sure they got in the hands of the right people that were affected. And then last week I sent down another 20,000 because we were a little short. I wanted to give all the responders and the Houston Police Department and just all the ones displaced. And there was a lot of towns south of Houston that were completely wiped out. So I think we got everybody covered. I'm going to check this week. I'm actually in Texas right now.
Where in Texas are you?
I'm in Lubkin, Texas. It's about an hour and a half from Houston.
You might be near me.
Well, maybe. Maybe we'll have lunch.
I'm in Brenham, Texas, so... Yeah. Well, tell me what you've been up to.
I've been really busy. I was getting my foundation ready to start to launch. I've been working about 2 years on that. I've got about $6 million into it, and it's the LindellFoundation.org, and that is where 100% of your money will go to the need, and I pay all the overhead, so there's no, and you get to hear back from the person the difference you made in their life. And we were going to launch in about a month, but I launched it in a small way early because of where it's just focused on Hurricane Harvey. And so we're launching that in about a week. I'm flying to Dallas in 2 days to meet my board. A lot of my board members are in Dallas. So that's been exciting. I've been over to India. We launched it in a lot of other countries to try it first and get all the bugs worked out of it, and then we're going to get in the U.S. here, and it's going to be a lot of help for the inner cities and stuff. You know, I used to be an addict, and help individuals get help, and doing a lot of that with private funds, helping people, and then I just hopefully get the country. Do as much help as I can possibly do to move forward here.
That's a great program. You know, I was talking to Glenn Beck. I believe I was on his program on Friday. And he's got a thing called Mercury One. And they give money to Operation Barbecue and a team. And there's another outfit they give money to. So Dave and I donated $100,000 to them. And they feed people affected by Harvey,
right?
And another good organization, and your organization is going to be specifically earmarked for to help addicts. Is that the deal?
No. That was originally what I was going to do. But it's going to be right now. You can actually go on there and donate to LindellFoundation.org, and it's 100% of the money is helping the victims of Hurricane Harvey. The platform is so amazing, because it's a pass-through entity where there's no overhead, where I pay all the overhead. But we are going to have, eventually I'll add to it, addicts, and, you know, you have opiate addictions that are just so bad in this country, and then veterans, and basically, homeless people. We're working in the big cities. We're going to be working with the homeless shelters. We're going to be working with all the good things that are going on within the city. I have a meeting with Teen Challenge, head of that, Union Gospel, Love, Inc., so many national organizations that I've met with personally to get this all set up. And
well, how does the money get distributed? I mean, once it goes to...
you're going to go on there, and you're basically going to be able to pick your need. Like, pick your square. You'll hear a story part about whatever it is, and then whatever you want to give, even if it's $5, and all these, you'll hear back from them. They're actually individual. You'll hear back from them online, the difference you made and where your money went, and I guarantee it gets there 100%. And this was the back.
The thing I didn't understand, Mike, is how does it get there?
I have validators and verifiers. To validate the need, and then I have verifiers set up that verify that the money gets there. We physically get it there. We have about six different methods that get it there. And that's where I have my money. I put about $6 million of my own money in to set up this amazing IT and back end of this website, all this technology. I don't know much about myself, but I told them what I wanted, and we've been building it for just shy of 2 years now. And it gets there through, like, let's say you're in a city and we have these validators set up. So all these individuals that are most of them are with other organizations that are doing it. It's like an extension of them, so they can help people. But otherwise, I do have paid ones, but they're paid by me. They're paid, the overhead's paid by me. So any of them that are out there physically working and meeting the people and making sure that the needs are real, because I get approached all the time for needs that aren't real.
Of course. What's the address again?
It's lindellfoundation.org.
LINDELL.
Yeah.
Lindellfoundation.org.
Yeah. It's I got tired of foundations and stuff where you don't know if all your money gets there, and then you don't know how much their CEOs are making, and you don't know.
Like the Red Cross.
Yeah. Well, I don't know, but you just worry about that. And I just wanted to make it so for the people where 100% of your money you can trust will get there, and or you get your money back. If something happens, you get your money back. I don't say, well, we'll put it somewhere else if it doesn't get there.
No, that's great. That's the way we ran the IMS Rants for Kids with Cancer. Did and I paid the administrative cost out of our own pocket. So all the money went to the kids.
Yeah, absolutely. You got all these big organizations. If they're so good, why don't they pay all the overhead then? If they want
exactly. All right, man. It's a great thing you're doing and giving away over 100,000 pillows to the folks in Houston. Good for you. It's always nice to talk with you. Thanks for your patronage here on the Irons of the Morning program. I appreciate it. Wyatt wears your patch at the rodeos. A lot of people ask him, say, "Are those my pillows any good?" Wyatt says, "Yeah, they are." So my horse sleeps on one.
I've told our story so many times when we first met, and you gave me a great start, and it's always an honor to be on your show, and it's been quite a run here. I have over 1,600 employees that thank you and everybody else out there now.
Well, you're a great guy. You're giving back to the community, and you're not full of it. And it's good for you. So, thank you very much, Mike Lindell, my pillow here on the I Miss the Morning program. Coming up next hour, we're going to talk with Dale Strawberry. Speaking of junkies, that boy's a junkie too. It's coming up on 11 till the hour. It is 11 till the hour.